What I'm going to do is I'm going to see if the next 1 hour I can spend with you in terms of my experiences on the businesses that I've been involved with, which is Shopper Stop, then I set up Hypercity, Solitop, Crossword, then Retail Association of India, and now a TRRAIN, which is a charitable trust, and working for the industry. And the only thing that I can share with you is the mistakes that I have made in the last 27 years of retail and 35 years of my career. Okay, and that could probably be the way that we take up and build up a 1 hour session on customer centricity. So begin with what I would like you to do is, I want each of these tables to discuss and come out with 3 issues that you have. It could be the last 2 days of experience, your journey of whatever 10, 12, 15, 20 years experience, whatever you had. Come out with each table with 3 major issues that you find that you would like to tackle for your customer. Are you with me? Three major issues that is facing you in terms of tackling your customers. Don't come out as individuals, come out as a table. I know there's a Skechers and a Puma together, you love each other, you hate each other. So come out with your common customer. Think of the customer, yeah? What we're trying to do is at the end of 1 hour, we want to say that if we have to create a customer-centric organization, okay, what is it that we need to do, yeah? And we're already delayed by 10 minutes, so I'll just give you 5 minutes for this, yeah? Meeting. Okay, you're putting up the 3 top challenges that you have towards building customer centricity. Customer challenges, okay? Let's apply 1 filter to this. The filter is, put those challenges which you as individuals can solve. Don't put the challenge which requires your boss or somebody outside their room need to solve, because this whole thing is about yourself, yeah? Have you got it? Things that you can take a decision. This whole 2 days program or whatever we are doing is to make you able to sort out a customer challenge. We'll talk about policies and organizations, okay? If you have all the 3 which can be solved here, fine. Okay, if there's anything which is outside, knock it off. So you are retaining all the 3 challenges that you have because you think you all can solve it. Wonderful. How are you all going? It's fine? All the 3 you can do it? Wonderful. Okay. All the 3 challenges you believe that you all can solve it?
No. Huh?
Oh, then you filter it out, filter it out, filter it out. Now let me tell you the first lesson on the customer part of it, is that a customer comes and meets you and he expects or she expects for you to solve her problem. Okay, have you heard of this? If you can't solve, she says, get your manager here. I'll talk to somebody else, okay? I am saying all of us are managers. So the first thing that we have to do is, in any process definition or designing is, you have to take ownership of the customer, okay? Because the easiest thing that we do in retail business, because a large organization is, this is my company's policy. Then you should have written the company's policy in your ad, na? Bade bade mein. Why do you write there, oh, Skechers will make you run 10 kilometers and Puma will make you run 11 kilometers or the other way? No, write there, all that is fine, but we will not give you exchange. We will not this service. No, so you have to take ownership. That's the first lesson of that, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to take each one of you decide who is going to share these 3 challenges from your table. So who will share from there? Yeah, whoever, please stand up. Who's from your side? Who's that? You're going to do it. From your table? You will do it. From your table? You will do it. Okay, so no, you will not do it. Give the mic to the lady. You will not do it. Give it to him. You will not do it. Give it to him. Okay? Come on. The second lesson is, customer never comes announced to say, I want to deal with so-and-so person. You don't know what the customer wants. You don't know who the customer wants to deal with. As an organization, as a brand, as a customer-centric organization, all of us have to be prepared to deal with the customer, all their challenges, all their issues and everything. Yeah? Okay. Let's talk about the 3 issues. Yeah, please, please. You have some time to add on. But when I ask you to stand, you should be ready. Customer will never wait for you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Okay. Go ahead.
So first we have exchange policy.
Can you increase that, please? Exchange policy. Okay?
Yeah. So we think there should be a uniformity in the policy.
No, don't give the solution. Just let's talk of what is the issue. Exchange policy is one. What else? Second one.
Second, we have negative feedbacks on social media, like Twitter platform.
Okay.
Then we have integration of stock availability.
Okay, third is?
And then we have, three.
Stock availability.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Would you like to share, please? Yeah, go ahead. Can we get the mic here, please? Or you have to be a little louder? I think they have, there are two mics. Yeah, please, go ahead. Yeah.
Retention of customers.
Okay.
How to handle difficult customers.
Okay.
And reach out to loyal customers.
Okay. Difficult customers and?
Loyal customers.
And loyal customers. Okay. Yeah, please go ahead. You have a mic here. Go ahead. One up. Yeah.
So I think that team has covered the customer retention.
We say
as a customer engagement, both are almost conveying the same.
No. Retention is different and engagement is different.
With respect to integrated with the loyalty, what we are talking.
Retention, engagement, loyalty. Okay. Yeah.
Second is on the pricing with respect to online and offline.
Mm-hmm.
Fluctuations in pricing as a customer.
Okay.
And third would be brand trust.
Or brand image.
In terms of qualities, after sales service.
Warranties and guarantee claims.
Yeah, I'm just repeating for all of you. Between the three of your table, you have said exchange policy. Yeah. Second is you're saying negative feedback. Yeah. Third is you're saying stock availability. Fourth, you're saying retention. Yeah. Fifth, you're saying difficult customer. Sixth, you're saying loyal customer. Seventh, between retention and engagement, this table has come out with another one. Eighth, you're saying fluctuation in pricing. And ninth, you're saying is brand trust. Yeah? Anybody believes you want to add anything between the three table, or you think these are the real important challenge? How many of you are in managerial positions where you have a team reporting to you? So all of you are in managing positions where, sorry, this is also a part of the team, or this is? I thought this was all professors and trust mark people. So I'm so sorry. No, I'm so sorry, you know. I'm so sorry. My mistake, you know, aap log bada senior aur seriously the to isliye mujhe. Oh, please tell me. I'm sorry, my mistake. Yeah. This is what happens in retail. Okay. This is what happens in retail. You judge a customer on the basis of what you believe that customer looks. And that's the fundamental mistake I made right now in front of you. Okay? I made a judgment that the three tables are the tables who are actually people coming from the organizations, and this table looks like very serious, so are all people who are monitoring something. Yeah? So that's a very important thing. You can never judge a customer. You don't know the customer's mind. We are talking about artificial intelligence, we are talking of machine intelligence, we are talking of predictions. Okay? But you don't know the mood at that point of time. A same customer comes to your store or comes online with a friend, different mood, with his wife, different mood, with his boyfriend, girlfriend, different mood, after a full day's work, a different mood, early morning, a different mood. So same Rakesh, Ramesh, Nagesh is different customer, different point of time. So the mistake that I made right in front of you, it was not planned. It just happened. Okay, it's the first mistake that we have to avoid. Don't judge the customer either sitting in your head office or sitting in the store or sitting on the region. So my mistake, my apologies. Please go ahead.
The issues.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Coming to the issues, the first is the REC process.
What is REC?
That is the redemption, exchange, and the compensation process, where we have a challenge in tackling the customer. Second is in terms of the staff skills, skills to tackle customer, and how do we look into, you know, upgrading their skill sets over there in tackling customers. Third is again to do with the customer demands in terms of the product, services, and prices.
Okay, so I'm just adding up this to the nine, the REC process, the skills to tackle customers, and the customer demands that you have. Yeah. So two lessons. So somebody can keep writing the lessons that I'm learning right as we are going through. Yeah. One is that don't judge the customer. What was the lesson before that?
Take ownership
of the customer. Okay. So. Well, it says somebody said skills, so I'll take it up. I'll take it at first. So my attempt will be to see if at the end of next 40 minutes, if you are able to tackle some of these solutions. But I feel that these are all sub-processes and issues that we are trying to manage. Okay, I think the most important thing about creating a customer-centric organization is the ethos and cultures of customer centricity. How important is customer for you? Okay, this could be at an organizational level, this could be at a region level, this could be at a store level. Have you all heard of organizations where there is some store, everything, the policy remains the same, but there's one region which performs better, there's one store which performs better. Yes. Everything else remaining the same. You also have you seen of organizations where if a store manager is transformed from one store to second store, the A store sales drops in and the B store sales picks up. Everything else remaining the same. Have you seen that?
Yes.
Now, why does that happen? It is because of the individual. He or she does something. I'm not even talking of the energies. Okay. The whole thing is about what is the ethos and culture of customer centricity that you develop in an organization. And that, to me, is most important. The story of this customer care associate that Mr. Roy came and spoke about actually happened because an associate left me in 92. And he left me because he said his father-in-law doesn't want to marry because he says that he's a sales boy, whereas actually he wanted to marry his daughter to a sales executive. Okay, so it was a designation without looking at what the person does. Yeah, so we said, oh, if designation is a problem, what should be the right designation? And the question that came in our mind is, what is our purpose? What's our job? Whether you are a CEO of a retail organization or a front-end associate, what's your primary job? What do you think is your primary job? You are taking care of your customer, okay? Irrespective whether the customer wants to buy, buys, or does not buy. Am I right? Okay, so we said that's the primary job. Then why should we have designations which are talking of the roles that we play? So instead of the designation being roles-led, we made the designation purpose-led. So everybody in the company is called customer care associate. I think that's even carries on even now, okay? The second important thing that happened is, if I am called a customer care associate, if I am on the floor, or I am in a train, I am in an aircraft, and I'm sitting to next somebody who is already a customer, or could be likely a customer, what would be my behavior?
Genuine smile.
It will be genuinely wanting to treat the person as a customer and take care of it. Yeah. So I think the fundamental thing of building a customer-centric organization is, what is our thinking on the ethos, cultures, and value? Does the customer come as the first point in every discussion? On every table, every process, is the customer sitting there? So for example, yesterday some of you who were probably there in the morning session that we conducted, what did we do? We said we CEOs can come and talk whatever we want. We are all gurus of talking. You know, we talk more. Okay. But what if a customer sitting right in the center? We are actually now talking of the customer being there. So I'm saying the first thing we have to discuss to say is, how do you build a customer-centric organization, customer-centric leadership, customer-centric team? Yeah? Are you all with me?
Yes.
Yeah. So if you do that, many of these nine things that you have said, maybe I will take one or two to say it gets automatically solved. Okay? So to create a customer-centric organization, the fundamental thing is, what are the culture, values, ethos? Okay, that each company has a different. But eventually, all retailers, all brands, whether you're selling Parachute, or you're selling Skechers, you're selling Puma, at the end of the day, you're selling to a customer. Whether you're selling a service or a product, you're selling to the customer. But the last mile connect in this business, and that's where the rubber hits the road, okay? The last mile connect in the business is very, very important to be empowered to take that customer decision. So like you are saying, somebody said, difficult customer. Is there any difficult customer? If you all are married, is there a difficult wife? Is there a difficult husband? No. Is a child born to say, I am going to be a difficult? No. Not at all. The customer has made an effort, okay, to come on Linking Road. There's a Nike shop, next to that there's a Skechers shop, next to that there's a Puma shop. She has decided to come into a Skechers shop or a Puma shop. Has she decided to say, I'm going to be a tough customer to Skechers? No. Okay, we'll talk about how a customer becomes difficult and why do we call a customer difficult. The customer, have any one of you gone to any shop to buy anything or any service saying, I'm going to be a difficult customer? No, difficult customer is an outcome of the process and the relationship that gets developed at that particular point of time. So for example, abhi to nahi tha, 91, 95, 96, I used to go to stores, you know, they used to say, hey, TP aaya. I don't know why it still happens. Okay. Suddenly, you know, Gujarati mein, Marathi mein, Hindi mein, I don't know Gujarati, Marathi, TP aaya. Means time pass karne aaya. Yeah? I'll tell you a story of how what they thought is time pass became a 100,000 rupee customer. If you know on Linking Road, there's a Titan shop next to the CEO's rules. Yeah? In the Titan shop, there's a customer, 68, 70-year-old customer, 15 years back, who came, okay, were eating paan, both husband and wife. He was wearing a dhoti. He came to get his strap changed. Okay, everybody's message went, strap change karne aaya hai. But as the person took the strap, he said, like 20 minutes. He was standing, the lady was standing. One associate came and said, sir, we have just launched Raga collections meant for a husband-wife pair. Can I show you that? Okay. He said, okay, he was doing nothing. He had his lunch. He had come from some place to visit his son and daughter-in-law. Cut the story short, in 20 minutes, he bought a pair of watches worth 35,000 rupees, 93, 94. He had come to replace a watch strap, which that time was 500 rupees. Now please tell me, was this customer a TP? Do you agree that we should not prejudge a customer? The first lesson. So I'm saying, as far as the customer is concerned, there's nothing called a difficult customer. Okay, we'll come to saying as to how a customer becomes difficult. It's part of a way we judge the customer. But let's go back. We are talking of empowerment. And that is the simple, single, most important way of building a customer-centric organization. Are you empowered to deliver the purpose of the organization at the last mile? If you're not empowered, look at every process in the organization which disempowers you. And cut that process out. I'm telling you, you'll have the most empowered organization and the most customer-centric organization anywhere in the world. And we'll talk of a few examples and take it across. Let's say a customer has come in. She bought a dress or she bought a shoe. A lot of people are from the shoe industry. And because of the kind of shoe, every time she's walking, she's tripping. And there's a likely chance her ankle will get hurt. Nothing is wrong with the shoe. Nothing is wrong with the customer. Her way of walking makes her trip with the shoe. She believes the shoe, there's a problem. She has hurt her ankle because of that shoe. She's coming to you with this problem. She is a customer who has already bought. So, pichle baar aayi thi, to 8-10,000 rupees aapke pocket mein dal ke gayi hai. Now, you please tell me, what would be the solution for this customer? How would you handle this customer? Somebody also said about return policy and all those things, exchange and refund, and tell me.
Firstly, we take the product on acknowledgement note to check the product defect.
That's the process.
Yeah.
Acknowledgement note. I'm saying, ek dil dhadakta hua, ek lady aapke paas aayi, ek dil dhadakta hua, aap khade ho wahan par. How would you deal? See, because what is happening to us is, we all get into process.
Right.
So,
you have to empathize, sir.
So you empathize with the customer. Yes, ma'am, we are so sorry about it. Let's look at what we can do about it. What next would you do? If, I'm cutting the time, if suppose you get to know that actually there's nothing wrong with the shoe, nothing wrong with the lady, it's just that her walking style and the shoe is making this happen and she's done this, she will not be able to use this shoe again and be a satisfied customer. Let's say if that is your conclusion, what would you do?
I believe since it is not a manufacturing defect, there is nothing wrong with the product also. But since it is a good customer, we will take special approval and exchange the product.
Would you agree?
Yes.
Would you agree with this? Would you agree? Now look
at... Logically, I'm satisfied.
Yeah, look at what happened now. I think he solved the problem of the customer except one particular line which is there. He said, I will take special permission. Okay? But he's almost solved the problem. The customer, if I was a customer, she's a customer, she's very happy about it. She realizes that nothing is wrong with the shoe. If there's a problem with the shoe, you have actually acknowledged that and you are saying, let me go and take a special permission, nothing wrong. But just imagine if organizational process was, in such cases, you can take a decision and say, yes, ma'am, you agree there's nothing wrong with the shoes. Yes, ma'am, I know that there's nothing wrong with you. It's just that the kind of shoe and your walking habit does this. Don't worry, I'll give you a new shoe. Pick up your shoe. What would happen to the customer? Delighted. For a moment, let's go back. You will go back to your company for a special permission. Now, tell me the process. How would you go back? What will you do?
I can call my boss directly and explain him the process. I explain him the problem. He'll give me the permission immediately.
So tell me out of your experiences, how many times, if you call your boss 10 times for such problem, how many times has the boss rejected your proposal?
Never.
So if it has never been rejected, what stops from the organization to make you empowered for this? Just imagine the difference between the two conversations. Okay, between the two conversations. Ma'am, we acknowledge, we're sorry about it, I will take permission and get you a shoe. Thank you very much, I'll come back. Ma'am, we acknowledge, don't worry, please take a shoe, we will take this as a refund.
See, here comes a difficult time, when we given on on the same time in exchange, we all have all the authorities to do it on the spot. But still what happens, the customer
Okay. So let's go a little deeper. All of you been in retail? I'm assuming 5, 7, 8 years. How many, what percentage of your customers?
Very less.
No, tell me a percentage. What percentage of your customers come wanting to cheat you?
I think there are like 0.01%.
I think it's 4 to 5%.
Still that 0.1% is also.
Okay. So no, he's saying zero. He's saying 0.5. He's saying 4. What are you saying?
It's like if you take a store, so for example, in clusters, it happens very repeatedly. But if you take it at a company level, it's very minuscule.
Okay. So I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you to all this because this is a real problem that you're talking of. I'm only saying these problems cannot be addressed at process level. Please try to understand, retail is a business where we always want to create processes. I'm saying if you can address the problem at a cultural level and create a process around it, okay, you will find customer centricity becoming much stronger. We'll come to that right across, okay? You all know what shrinkage is?
Yes.
Yeah? What do you think is the average shrinkage in this country? Across retail, across, or maybe between your three companies? He's saying 1.2, 1.3, 0.5. Okay. The industry average in India is approximately about 1%. Global average is 1.5. Good organization in the country, at least I know some of you very closely, between 0.3 to 0.5 to 0.6. Yeah? So when you look at this, isn't this planned as part of your budget? Yeah? When you do the budgeting, don't you take shrinkage as part of your budget? So, jo chori ho sakta hai, kharab ho sakta hai, employee chori kar sakta hai. You also agree that in shrinkage, 60% of the shrinkage is happening because of employee coalition? It's established across, 50 to 60%. So, jo employee chori mein aap apne budget mein shrinkage mein le sakte ho, to aise customer ka kyun nahi budget mein shrinkage mein le sakte ho? Are you getting me? Okay, let us say that you will have some questions. Fair enough, I'll answer that. But let us say you take this. And then you set up a process that for every refund that happens on these, you have a process to check on the credibility of the refund. Are you getting me? So let us say any refund that happens, any exchange that happens, go through a process. There's a crate note. You have to write for size, for defect, for color, for bleeding, multiple things, okay? And you also have a reason to say customer dissatisfied, okay? So let us say that this comes under customer dissatisfied, and you as an organization decide that anything which is customer dissatisfied, you know, your boss knows, your CEO knows, would be looked into, just to be sure. Okay, in this case, it goes as customer dissatisfied. You have taken the decision without asking your boss. It goes to the top in the audit or in the CRM or in the whatever. The person picks up the call and talks to the lady and says, ma'am, I just want to talk to you. Your shoes were not all right. You went to a Linking Road store and this gentleman, Farhan, actually gave you an exchange. How was the exchange? Got it? If you get to know this was a fraud, Farhan ka gala katega, the customer ko to gaya gaya. Is this a better method for you than making all the customers who come with this not being attended to or not being empowered? I'm leaving this with you. Yeah. Can we request them to close the door or not allow? The people coming in between has no meaning at all. Yeah. So, are you with me? I would like you to raise questions in case if you are not with me, because all of us have to either agree or disagree. If anybody disagrees, you should. Because what you should be doing is, you should go back into your business tomorrow, day after, look at all these such processes, pick any one process which you think can be systemically solved. Please understand, as managers in retail, we try to solve problems at locations and occasions. No. You have to, irrespective of whether you're a CEO or a store manager, doesn't make a difference. Every time you address a problem, you get a solution, immediate question is, can we solve this in a systemic way? Which means, Linking Road store mein nahin, abhi Skechers ke, Puma ke, Shoppers ke, Lifestyle ke, har store mein ye problem solve ho jayega, because we made it into a process. Are you all with me? Yeah? So that to me is the first way of building a customer-centric organization, which is, can you empower your last mile? Okay, and the way to empower your last mile is to go through all processes which disempowers the last mile. See, one of the highest demotivation for an associate or a store manager is when the customer believes that he or she is powerful, whereas the organization conveys that he or she is not powerful. Customer jab aata hai, to customer ye soch ke nahi aata hai ki mujhe CEO se phone karke mere ko solve karna padega. Customer comes and says, you are the associate, you will solve my problem, he's the store manager, you'll solve the problem. Dukandar khatam kar dega. Agar aap kisi dukan pe jate ho Irla pe, to ye thodi bolta hai ki main apne bujurg se puch ke aata hu. He solves it. Wo hum hi log hain jo avoid karne ke liye bolte hain bujurg se puch ke aayenge, matlab CEO se puch ke aayenge. No. So first is, can you empower? Second is, can you find out all the processes which disempowers you, and can you systemically solve some of those processes, okay? In my life journey of 27 years, we took this decision very early, 94, 95, okay? I have seen the store people and people on the front end being much more cautious than the head office people, because they know the situation. आपको पता है कि क्या प्रॉब्लम है, यू नो द सिचुएशन. हेड ऑफिस का जब भी कस्टमर फोन आता तो जल्दी अवॉइड करना चाहता है द प्रॉब्लम. हाँ ले लो, अरे यार दे देना उसको एक गिफ्ट, खत्म. बिकॉज दैट्स द रियलिटी. हेड ऑफिस इज इन मुंबई, द प्रॉब्लम इज कमिंग फ्रॉम गुवाहाटी. आई हैव नॉट बीन टू गुवाहाटी इन माई लाइफ, सो हाउ कैन आई सॉल्व अ गुवाहाटी कस्टमर्स प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट वे टू क्रिएट अ डीएनए एंड अ कल्चर ऑफ क्रिएटिंग अ कस्टमर सेंट्रिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. या नाउ लेट्स लुक एट इट. अगर हम कस्टमर सेंट्रिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बना देते हैं, so please tell me, how many of you think you will have a difficult customer? Because all the difficulties you solve. And honestly, if you look at it, all policies in retail, all policies, aap jaake dekh lo, jab se Skechers shuru hua, Puma shuru hua, talk to Mr. Abhishek, talk to all your senior, jitne bhi policies aapke company mein bane hain, wo 1% customer ki wajah se bane hain. All policies are made on the basis of problems faced by 1% customer, because nobody has ever sat in a group like this to say what are the policies for the 99% customer. So when you're looking at this trust, or when you look at the trusted mark, what is the purpose? The purpose is to say, can you identify policies which are meant for the 99% of the customer and solve that for them, because only then do you get an organization which is absolutely customer-centric. Okay? So if anybody thinks that, no, you can't solve the difficult customer, let's go. Because I'm trying to just take one point and help you to say you can solve most of that. Okay? Loyal customers. Okay? Please tell me, jab customer aapke dukaan mein aata hai, okay, Puma ko chhod ke, Nike ko chhod ke, Skechers mein aata hai, Shoppers Stop ko chhod ke, Lifestyle mein aata hai, to wo aapke dukaan mein andar aane tak, aapne kya kiya uske liye? If you are inside the shop, or if you are working in the head office, what have you done for the customer? Nothing. Aapne kuch nahi kiya abhi to. Abhi to wo andar aapke dukaan mein aaya hai. Visual merchandising kiya hai, but uske paas visual merchandising Puma mein bhi tha, Skechers mein bhi tha, aur aapka relevant hai, to aa gaya wo, theek hai? But he has made a choice to come into your store. Are you with? So he or she has made more effort than you at that particular point to come into your store. So please tell me, at this point, is she more loyal or you more loyal?
Naturally, customer is more loyal.
She's more loyal, yeah? So I think the first question you have to ask is, what is this whole thing about loyalty program? Okay, within this room, there's no press. Loyalty program is not having a pet dog with a leash. Ki mera kutta hai, mera customer hai. No, loyalty program is a relationship that you build with a customer who starts coming repeatedly. It's unfortunate that we believe that customers who come repeatedly and who have a loyalty card are our loyalty program. Do you know that there are customers who are much more loyal and spend much more without being a part of a loyalty program?
Yes. Yes.
So what do you do with those customers? You do nothing, because you don't recognize the customer, he's not part of your system, he doesn't flash a card. So the important is understanding the definition of what a loyalty program should be, or what the loyalty program is. I'm not getting into the process of a loyalty program. I'm again coming back into the culture, because for me, any customer-centric organization can be only built by building a good DNA and a good culture. When you build a good DNA and good culture, convert that good DNA, good culture into a process which can be adopted by everybody, whether he's a 10-year-old employee or a new employee. Because that's the way you keep building and keep evolving the organization as you go forward. Yeah? So, if you can look at everything that you do to make the customer loyal, okay, which means you have to become loyal to the customer rather than the customer becoming loyal, and especially in today's world, it is becoming very, very, very important. Okay? So let's start with what Amitabh said. We say we want to have a very strong loyalty program. Okay? Let's say that's the definition. And we are saying, in our loyalty program, we'll do everything to make ourselves loyal to our customer. Yeah? Which means, I'm not getting into advertising and things like that, because it'll take a lot of time. Let's just start from the window. Don't you think it is my responsibility as a Puma store manager to have a window equal or better than Skechers Next?
Yes.
Yeah. Don't you think it is my responsibility to ensure that the right product is displayed? My responsibility to ensure that the product that is displayed is full in stock? Because if your highest loyal customers enter your store, looks at that window and says, that's fantastic, can I have that? And you say, ma'am, that's my fastest seller. I've heard this film. Ma'am, it's the fastest seller, it's the best seller, it's gone. So why the hell have you put it on display outside?
Correct.
You should have removed it. Okay? So now you look at every element of things that you do. Every element. We discussed one is the refund exchange. We discussed the centricity issue. Look at the windows. Every element that you in a store, which actually builds towards your loyalty. Now look at, what do you think is the availability in the industry of in fashion? Fashion footwear. What is the availability at a store level? Somebody was discussing availability at that table, but what is the stock availability, you think, for the customer? What is the percentage of availability for the customer? 50%. The industry average is much higher, but...
No, it has to be somewhere around 80 to 90%.
So I'm saying, let us say it is 80 to 90%, yeah. I mean, it depends, between 75 to 80, 85%, yeah. Now look at the loyalty. The loyal customer has come into your store, she liked the window, she has entered it, she wants to shop the particular product, that product is not available because your availability is 85%. Now, who's more loyal, the customer or you?
The
customer is more loyal. Your loyalty means that my customers come all the way to buy this product. How do I ensure that she gets that product? That product availability is 85%. In today's world, you can make it 100% or closer to 100% by doing the end of file using technology, using online. But the question is not that. The question is the organization culture there to empower me to go all the way? That's the important part of it. So product is not there. Yes, ma'am, the product is not there. It's gone. Give me 10 minutes or 2 minutes. Please sit down. My friend will show you other product, which is like the same product. Very likely chance you'll sell some other product to her. But let me check it up. In the 5 minutes, all of you have connected store to check up which store it has. Okay, and you also say, ma'am, it is there in this store. I will get you by tomorrow. Yeah. In fact, in this year, one of the awards that we do in TRRAIN, one of the guys who actually won the award from Goa as a person who had an American customer who had to get a laptop. And she was leaving the next day morning. And the laptop was available in a city which was 360 kilometers away. And he, in the evening, left at 5 o'clock and came back at 5 o'clock in the morning, or 12 or 14 or 15 hours, whatever it took. He went, picked up the laptop, came back and delivered to her airport before she goes. Okay. Now, to me, that is the loyalty of the individual. Now, you will say, "Arey, wo to individual tha usne kar diya." No. The question is, why can't this become the ethos of the organization? Okay, he must have spent 600-700 rupees to go and come. If he comes back and says this, would the store manager, when he comes in the morning, say, "Ye kya 700 rupees ka bill diya?" "Nahi sir, main wo 600 kilometer gaya tha, wo customer ke liye." "Pagal ho gaya kya? Ye bill nahi clear karenge. This is not part of my policy." Will that be the thing? Or if he says, "Ek minute, ruk," call everybody, clap for the guy to say what he has done, take a photograph, send it to head office, ask them to put it in all the awards. What will create more customer-centric organization?
Second one.
So I'm saying, look at each of these elements for yourself. Again, every time I'm talking to you, I want you to please look at the workshop that we're sitting here. Everything that we do has to get converted into a process which, as part of the whole trust mark, becomes part of the organizational ethos, so that the next time, that becomes the base level. So in this case, what is the process? The process is, we will not let our customer down at any cost. Okay, now this is not a process. This is a promise. And this promise becomes part of your organizational culture. At the end of the year, you say, how many such cases we had? You find 100 cases. What was the cost of doing this, not let my customer down? 1,70,000 rupees. What is 1,70,000 for a 600 crore company, 1,000 crore company, 4,000 crore company? Nothing. But look at what the customer has got. Are you all with me?
Yes.
Yeah? I won't be able to cover everything, but what I want you to remember is that when you empower, when you want to create a customer-centric organization, the first is the ethos and the culture. Second is you empower. Third is, after you empower, you realize whatever you say, how much is the customer's role and how much is my role? In retail, all problems, you put it on the customer or the head office. Yeah? In head office, you go, all the customers put on the CEO or the stores. Stocks have gone, they don't sell. If you go to the store, they say, you know, availability is not there. Ye bik raha, ye aata hi nahi hai. Dusra wala jo nahi bik raha, wo continuously bhej rahe. But if you look at it in retail, and that's how I started this discussion, never, never, never say what he did not do or she did not do. Retail is all about what is it that I have done. So question is, you had 85% availability. What did you do with the 85% availability? You're always talking about the 15% non-availability. You're always talking about the customer. So ethos and culture is, what can I do with this and make it better? Yeah? And again, I'm repeating, because we are talking of trusted, we are talking of 2 days of exercise that you have done. Please convert always the good things into a process. After that, put it into a system. After that, back it up with a technology. Okay, and today's world, you can even put an FAQ of all this in your organization. So there could be an FAQ. I have a customer who has no problem with the shoes. The shoes doesn't have a problem, but she's hurting her ankle every time she wears. What should I do? It'll go back and say, you know what, Fazal in Mumbai had solved the customer's problem like this. This is what it is, and the company had approved it. That's how you translate a particular culture from one shop to one region across, okay? Anything on the loyal customer or difficult customer that you want? We'll then come to the engagement part of it, because then it'll tie it up. Any opinion, anything that you, if you all don't agree to anything, please stand up and say that, because that will be my learning. But if you agree to everything, then I don't know what my learning will be. Yeah? Okay, let's come to the third issue that you sort of engagement. You're talking of engagement with customer or engagement with employees?
Customer engagement.
Okay. So, one of the things that we see is, what is an engaged customer? Or let's not even call a customer. What is an engaged relationship? Two-way communication. Say it loud. If you say good things, don't say it loud.
Two-way communication.
Two-way communication. Okay? What else? What are the elements which build a great relationship?
Sending the right message.
Two-way communication, sending the right message.
Transparency.
Trust. Trust is the outcome of various things that you do, and that trust helps you build relationship. Okay? So that's one. What else? Understanding the needs of whatever. Again, I'm not talking customer. My relationship ki baat kar raha. Toh aap dimaag mein, you can talk of your fiancé, you can girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, wife, children, mother, mother-in-law, grandfather, everywhere. Because at the end of the day, whoever comes into your store is a ticking heart, a human being who's coming. And, sorry?
Presence
at that point of time? Yeah.
Commitment.
To be able to listen. Okay. Get the feedback, which is able to listen, okay? So there are lots of points coming in. I won't get into all the points, but what does it really mean? It means that you are also in the business of retail. You are doing exactly the same thing. You are getting into a relationship, which could be a one transaction relationship, which if ends up into building of trust, converts into a transaction. Are you there? Have you ever seen a customer buying anything when she or he doesn't trust your product or you or your company or your brand?
No.
There's no way. And you don't have to have a brand to build a trust. Yeah? I mean, if you look at it, Chitle Bandhu in Pune is a big brand. I don't know how many times they've advertised in the years. They have used a technology on the POS, which was launched in 1991, which even today nobody knows how that works. But one of the fastest checkouts in this country is Chitle Bandhu. And fractional mithai, 112 gram, aapka wo bill karta hai aur 5 minute mein nikal deta hai. Aapke dukaan mein 112 gram aayega to 15 minute lagega nikalne mein isko. And it's amazing. You all should go and actually see that as to how they do the checkout. It's a brand. The brand gets built because of the trust. Lot of us feel that advertising and branding builds the trust. No. It is this transaction, is this relationship which builds the trust, and every time a trust relationship builds and it becomes multiple transactions, it's like an onion, it adds a beautiful layer to your brand. Over a period, the brand becomes very, very solid. Yeah? So you had one transaction because of listening, because of serving, because of feedback, and when this transaction happens first time, second time, third time, fourth time, it start developing into relationship. And when you give a stamp to the relationship, it becomes a loyalty program. Go back into life. Same thing. You actually want to put a stamp to the dating to make into a marriage, then that becomes a loyalty program. I am Mr. So-and-so and she is Mrs. So-and-so. Till that time, it is only relationship. Okay, but remember one thing, between the transaction, that one transaction that first time happened, and the multiple transactions that you have, is what we call as the lifetime value of customers. Yeah, and for us in retail, we have to work out a process to understand what is the lifetime value of a customer. Abhi to the AI has come, lots of things have come, but even in the absence of that, through the use of loyalty programs, you will actually establish the lifetime value of customer. So, aap ye dekho, that elderly gentleman and his wife, who went to get a scrap change for 500 rupees, spent 35,000 at one go. They don't live in Mumbai, they came from some other place. But if the parents can spend 35,000 to gift, maybe the children whom they had come would be as rich or may have as much of spend. So, did the store manager get into a conversation with the person and say, sir, wonderful sir, aap kahan se aaye hain sir? आप लिंकिंग रोड में कहाँ रहती है आपका बेटा बेटी कहाँ रहते हैं वो क्या करते हैं सर आप उनका नंबर दो ना हम उनको भी एक अपनी तरफ से कुछ थैंक यू मैसेज भेजते हैं What have you done here? You have built a lifetime value with a household and not a customer. See, we all talk about saying apna like-to-like sales nahi badh raha hai, repeat customer nahi aa raha hai, retention nahi aa raha hai. You know, the advertisement is not getting you customer entry. But these are all myths. 80% of our industry is still traditional. They don't advertise. They're still growing at 7 to 8%. How are they growing? It's all because of this. One conversation, in fact, when he said listening and he said talking, it's actually conversation. Ability to build conversation. So again, from here, if you have to go back to the trust mark, as an organization, in your training program, have you got a program how to build conversation? Okay, I can take an hour of talk on how to build a conversation, but just to leave your thoughts, because you are operating the business, you can only build a conversation when you know the subject. Okay, and you can only build a conversation when the subject is not the product. Have you seen that? He comes in and he's looking at the shirt rack. May I help you? No. Khatam hi ho gaya. Gone. Yeah. He has come and looking at the shirt and you're saying, that's a beautiful shirt, sir. Last week we actually sold 12 of them. What is the likely question from the customer? You opened up a conversation. Okay, or it's raining in Mumbai, the customer has come in, and you are saying, abhi aage isko ye wala juta bechunga, ye wala shirt bechunga. No. So have you by any chance got wet? Do you want me to give you a towel? Open up a conversation. Okay, we were in Alaska. We went to a very small place. We went to have a cup of coffee. We ended up spending 1 hour. Because the lady who was serving, she has spent 6 months hitchhiking in India. She knew more about India than us. And she started talking about India, and we got into conversation. So, chai peene gaye the, khana bhi khaya, dessert bhi khaya, wo $20 ka bill hala, $200 ka bill ho gaya. And she did not sell anything. And each one of you must have seen, aapke har dukaan mein aise ek bande, do bande, teen bande honge, jo is tarah ka conversation karte hain. Hum unko best salesman karke chhod dete hain. No. Please understand, how do they build the conversation? Again, I'm going, see, because we are sitting in a class which is a trust class, again, I'm telling you, at every incident, a successful CEO, a successful manager is one who can capture every good incident and convert that into a process which is systemic and repeatable. Just doing the process is not enough. Because you have linking road process, your linking road is increasing. But what is the benefit? Your linking road has to go up, Mumbai has to go up, Western region has to go up, all India has to go up. And that's the only reason you will grow, because somebody will recognize that iske dukaan se to every day there is a new spark coming in. So, when you're talking of relationship, building relationship through a conversation, having a transaction, repeating the transaction, getting into a loyalty relationship, building a trust, endorsing the trust with a loyalty program card is what completes the cycle. Are you all with me?
Yes.
Anybody would want to debate or say something else about this? But I have covered 4 of your issues and challenges that you talked of.
Loyalty program cards, what I see is when you shop, it's like a date when you're not meeting that set amount
Redeem.
Or the value cutoff. They're like, you know, kind of wanting to force that, okay, you buy something which we really don't want just with the tag that you may get something. You know, sometimes as a customer we get offended. So like, how do you ensure, like we see they are wanting to push the value or
so,
the price.
So the problem is that we are mistaking 3-4 elements of a process. Building a sale, selling a product, increasing the average transaction value by using the ASP, multiplying by the number of units, and connecting the loyalty program. So, yahan tak sab theek tha. Yahan loyalty program mein connect karke aapne wo loyalty program ko badmaash. Just imagine, again, go back to relationship. If you are a parent, go to a parent-child relationship. If you are a mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, go to that. If you are husband-wife, look at in any relationship. When you try to bring a tag or a value to the relationship does not remain a relationship. So, if you separate this and do everything else, it's perfect. We are there. I mean, please understand, we are here in a retail to sell. Danda hai, maal bechna hai. That we can't run away from. But maal bechne ke liye, there are 10 things that you can do. But don't end this with this. This should be the outcome. Like Amitabh said, the trust has to be an outcome. The loyalty has to be an outcome. Oh, loyalty card and program is just a name that you're given to recognize. Aapas mein kaise pehchanoge? Okay, if you want to build it up, sir. Seeing you after a long time, ma'am. I know you are a first citizen. No, I'm not a first citizen. Oh, I'm sorry. Come, I'll make you a first citizen. Opened up a conversation. You can open up a conversation with negative statement, positive statement. But again, remember, since you all have spent 2 days, anything that you learn, go back, experiment, convert that into a process, send it back into your organizational system, ask others whether that can work, cascade up, you will go back and your organization will see that you are come back doing a great job. On difficult customer, loyal customer, engagement, any questions you have? Skills to tackling also we have covered some part, but I'll cover. On these three, any questions, any doubt, anything that you want to say, anything that you don't agree? If you look at this, there are two or three elements. We're getting into slightly a different discussion, but since you raised it, let me point this up.
Isn't it related to what we said, conversation?
100%. The average industry attrition is 7% a month. So 84% banda to aapka saal mein bhi nahi ruk raha hai. Okay. The average industry salary is 12,600 rupees. 12,000 average hai, to usme Tommy Hilfiger, IKEA, some of the brands who are sitting here are paying 16,000, 17,000 rupees. Okay, many of the brands are paying minimum wage of 8,300 rupees. There are challenges, and as part of TRRAIN, Amitabh, you know I do this. There are challenges where we are not trying to address the basics. So if you are not wanting people who can really contribute and converse, how will it happen? Okay, so there are. This is where I think, but you can also get people, align them to the purpose, train them, and they will get into conversation. Yes, Amita, but let me tell you that if I go to traditional stores, I know of stores where the salary is 2,500 plus khana plus rehna. Huh? But wo banda jaan laga deta hai. Wo banda kuch bhi karega, aayega karega. So it is not just the money part of it. Money is one important part. The question is, how do you align the person to the purpose? Here, we are not even talking an associate. You are all people who have been supervisory, managerial role, I'm sure you are being paid better than those guys. The question is, in this kind of a group also you go across, there are challenges. Because you're not aligned to the purpose, you're not aligned to the customer centricity, you're not want to be aligned to what the organization wants. But once you get that in, it happens. So money is important. But more than money, since you raised this question, 90% of the time when I speak to people, they tell me there are only two things. I don't get respect from my colleagues and my supervisor. That's the first thing that they say. The second thing they say is, they don't help me grow. That's all they want, nothing else. I can challenge you. Aaj aap jitne bhi 20 log ho, aap ye laga lo. Kal se if you just decide ki yaar, main har bande ko aisa respect dunga ki usko, he should really good, feel good. And I will spend 1 hour a week training them. And skilling them in such a way that all of them can take my role. And make me redundant, or the company has to throw me out.
There's also one problem that ownership nahi hai. That is because of which attrition, we talk about attrition.
So let me ask a quick question. How many of you are owners here?
We all are owners because.
So why is everybody not raising their hand?
We own our own business.
So that's okay. Negative feedback. Brand trust. So I'll come to the brand trust. But let me address these two things, exchange policy and negative fee. Where is the question of exchange policy? in today's world, when the world is now doing exchange with no questions asked. So you have to look at a policy which is to say, I will satisfy my customer. Let me give you one example. And again, very old example. It happened in Pune, Shivaji Nagar, Shoppers Stop. I'm giving examples of my time when I used to run the business much closely. A couple was shopping, and the husband was very keen to buy a silk kurta pajama. Yeah? And the wife was saying that you buy a cotton one, okay? Because she said we can't afford this 5,000, 6,000 rupees. But he insisted, whatever happened, she bought. It seems he went back, and for whatever reason, after he wore, he did not see the label, and he put it into a first wash. And that 6,000, 7,000 rupee garment came with bleeding all over the place. It was a messed up garment. They had a big fight. All that happened in how this guy came back to our store to say, can anything be done? He didn't come to exchange. He just said, can anything be done with it? Because he thought maybe some treatment, something will happen. The store manager or whoever attended knew that nothing can be done about this. Yeah? But he saw his face. He saw his thing. He knew it was his mistake. He said, sir, you please take a... You take whatever you want. He gave him the exchange. The company wrote off. It was the decision of the store manager. So we must have lost 6,000 rupees. Ho gaya, khatam ho gaya. Life kept going on. We saw that there's one company in Pune which is continuously giving us institutional orders, GVs and institutional sales. It was running in lakhs and lakhs and lakhs. So actually, at some point, somebody started saying, how is this happening? And then they realized that the admin manager of the company was this gentleman. Now please look at it. When he was trying to do this, he didn't know his admin manager. He didn't know that he's doing it because mere ko gift voucher ka sale milega. So I'm saying when you do service genuinely, when you want to keep your customer happy, the question is, do you want the customer to go unhappy? Aap kabhi ye chahoge ki customer jo hai, agar aapka kapda pehna hua hai aur acha nahi lag raha hai, to aapke brand ke upar haath leke ghume aise. Because he doesn't want to show ki yaar khatra hai, but I can't, I have spent 2,000 rupees, but nobody should know what brand is. No. So if our ultimate objective is to keep our customer happy, then where is the question of us not, theek hai yaar, gadbad ho gaya, galti har kisi se hota hai. These are part of your budgeting. You should have the guts to tell your bosses, boss, ek kaam karo na, you are asking for 1% shrinkage. Na? Aap ek kaam karo, 1% shrinkage comes to 1 lakh rupay. Theek hai? Main 1 lakh shrinkage pe hi rakhta hun. Main sale thoda 1% bada dunga. Allow me to do what I want to do for the customer. Because you are the owner. Genuinely, all of you are owner. So once you do that, you realize that actually no customers comes to cheat you here. Only 1% customers are bad. Only 1% people are terrorists. Only 1% people have wrong intention. 99% of humanity doesn't have wrong intentions. Yeah, hum log ke dimag mein hai because we want to create policies like that. Yeah? So in my opinion, today's world when online is giving you free exchange, cashback in 30 days, same customer, same product, very unlikely. But have a strong process to check the genuinity of exchanges that are happening. That's a process that you have to have. Like I said, have 5-6 elements. If there are elements, then you will get to know. For example, if you have loyalty programs you run, or you have through the mobile, you do a search, go to mobile and create an algorithm. Okay, you find out who's the customer who buys more, who's the customer who buys sneakers more, who's the customer who buys trackpants more. Just look at saying who's the customer whose exchanges are the maximum. You'll get to know. And you'll find there's one customer, one lady, one man who keeps coming for exchanges. So next time, Fazal knows that agar she has come with the exchange, he says, ma'am, wonderful, but last time also we exchanged, what happened, what do you do, how do you do? That's the conversation you build. And there, under no circumstances, you give an exchange. Because you know this is historical, because the moment you start supporting a customer whose intention is to cheat you, your staff will know, boss, aisa hai toh hum bhi kar sakte hain. Baki log bhi kar sakte. That's wrong. So supporting a negative or doing a wrong deed and supporting that as a supervisor manager is not a good process. So you have to have a process to actually check up how do you manage the whole exchange policies. This negative feedback is what? Employee feedback, customer feedback? Customer is king. We just said you have to listen. And what is this? Can somebody explain to me a little more on this negative feedback? What is the concern? What is the worry?
About the feedback which we receive on social media, like if one customer is unhappy, he will go on social media, he will tweet.
So can I just repeat your statement? If one customer is unhappy. So you are saying unhappy customer putting things on social media.
It's not about the unhappiness. It's about if we are not able to assist customer with service. Like, we know that this customer is a repeat offender and he's taking the benefit of what policy we go through. So if he's taking the advantage of it and if he's putting on social media and he's started tweeting, so many of the customers start following the same and they also follow the same.
What percentage of your overall customers would be doing this? So like I said, 1%, na? So sometime aap aise so rahe ho na, to takiye mein aise karke aise so jao. Life goes on. See, please again understand that if you start doing everything to support and defend this one customer who has created negativity, you will get into a loop. So that's why they say that when you have this kind of social media, you have to be very sure how do you react to this. A lot of organizations I see, they defend. No, it did not happen. No. Maybe it's happened. Or maybe the customer's expectation was different. We are in a business where customer has an expectation. So when you meet that expectation, unfortunately, if you look at it, more customers go to social media to create negative issues rather than saying that I had a fantastic service. You know, we run this award called the TRRAIN Retail Awards, and I have seen this. Forget even the employers, the businesses. We have forgotten the way to appreciate things. Yeah, I mean, you look at your own team. If you have 6 people, just find out ki din mein kitne baar aapne apne team ko appreciate kiya hai. Any one of you, tell me. Kyunki agar aap achieve kar rahe ho, to acha kaam ho raha hoga, tabhi achieve kar rahe ho. To iska matlab din bhar acha kaam ho raha hoga, tabhi achieve kar rahe ho aap. Isn't it? To agar din bhar acha kaam ho raha hai, to din mein kitne baar appreciate kiya? Just go and check it up. I'll challenge you, just look at just this one aspect of just saying, yaar, maza aa gaya, aaj tere se seekhna hai. Huh? You can use some, aapas mein baat kar, tere se seekhna hai, yaar, tu kaise customer ko patata hai. And next day morning, hey guys, 10 o'clock before the store opens, I want to tell, what's your name?
Harish.
I want to, wait a minute, I want Harish, aaja yaar. Tell me, how do you do this? Just do two of these things. You have appreciated him yesterday and today in publicly, you're not appreciating him. You're telling him, we want to learn from you. So every time there's an appreciation, learn. Now, this also can be converted into a process. So all of us as a rule have that pre-opening session in the store, okay? Or in your own department, if you're in head office doing buying, merchandising, whatever, all of us have that 5-10 minutes of huddle or morning, okay? The process is, in that huddle, what all you bring in? If you go to a hotel or a restaurant, they have a huddle. All of them. 7 baje agar restaurant mein 5 pehle chale jao, all of them are sitting, standing all around. What are the things they discuss in the huddle? Okay? We'll take a restaurant example and take a retail example. In the restaurant, they discuss, what is the menu for today? What is the special menu? What is that item that we want to sell more? Who are the likely guests coming? And there is a table which has been booked by a party for a certain thing. So all of us know ki agar us table pe hai, then that's an important guest, maybe loyal guest or whatever, whatever, whatever. All of us know that that particular item is the star of today. Okay? Yesterday, we beat our budgets. We clap. Yesterday, Fazal did this. Harish did this. We clap. Okay? Or, you know, Harish served, the customers came back and they clapped for Harish. Tune kya kiya yaar? He talks about it. Just 4, 5, 6 things, it takes 10 minutes. And that becomes then a process. Yeah? Today problems bhi is process. Ke. Ye kahani hai, sunata hon agar, we close at 1:30, na? Yeah. Sunata hon, 5 minute time milega, to I'll tell you ki jab is tarah ka process banate hain, to process mein kaise problem ho aata hai. It's an old story in Shop Stop only. I have said this many a times. If you heard, it's a different thing. So I used to do this when I was running the store. I'm talking very early times. So a customer came and bought a tie, lady. And we heard her, not I, but one of our associates heard her saying that she's giving it for his birthday. So between the time the tie was picked and went to the cashier, this gentleman went and got it gift-wrapped, okay, and put a nice card on top of it, put it in the bag, and the cashier gave it, she went home. When she went home, she realized, shit, I should have got it packed. I forgot to get it packed. She opened it, and it was gift-wrapped. Oh, she was delighted. She was delighted. She came back next day. Chota sa, we were just 30, 40 people in Andheri, and we clapped for everybody and everybody. And the next day morning, I shared this with everybody. I said, you know what? Keep your ears open. The customer is saying, occasion, think of the occasion, get it gift-wrapped. So everybody got it, and it became a process. Yeah. After a few days, there's a customer who came shouting, firing, hey, oh. So he said, what happened? So that customer came to buy a lingerie for his wife, girlfriend, we don't know whom. And he said, you know, I don't know how what lingerie, I want to gift. So kisi ko ek gift sunai de gaya. To uska dimag process pe gaya ho. To customer ne khareed liya, gift le liya, bhag ke gaya department, bola, yaar, isko gift wrap kar de. Usne gift wrap kar diya, sab dal diya. Customer was very happy, wife was very happy, her girlfriend, she opened it. Usme jockey men's underwear ka dabba tha. So everything went right. Intention was right. He wanted to surprise the customer. There's nothing wrong. Where the process went wrong is at the packing department, the process went wrong saying ki agar lingerie hai to lingerie ka dabba dalo, tie hai to tie ka dabba dalo. Usne liya jo dabba niche se mila wada usne. So again, understand, when you're converting any of the discussions that we have had in the last 1 hour, when you convert into the process, please don't do macro process. You have to do micro, which means every element has to be looked at it. Every link has to be looked at it. From one end to another end, you have to take a link. If ever I get a time, I can take a small micro process and break it into micro, 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 micro to the extent of... Aapne dekha hai, humare yahan restaurant mein, jab paani dalte hain, to aise karke dalte hain. Have you seen that? Is it respect? It could be respect. A lot of people think respect is aise dera paani. It could be because if there is some dirt in the hand and he's giving it like that, both the hand, left hand is used for multiple purposes. It's always the right hand you give. So please understand, when you do a process, go into micro, micro, micro element, especially when you want to implement it. Second is, if something new has come up, like jo maine kahani bataya, when you want to do this process, when you want to look at the incident, convert to a process, always do a small pilot. So, ek baar dekh lo. So, for example, agar ye process, us time to I was 32, 33, kisi ne padhaya nahi, samjhaya nahi, ta kar diya. But agar aaj karna hai, to I would say, what are the category of items which go into our packaging? Okay, and do we have boxes which are all the packaging? And now, I will have only one common box, which is all Shopper Stop box. So, I will not have. Us time kya hota tha? We used to get boxes from suppliers. Wohi box ko hum log recycle karte the. To galti ho gaya. Jute bhi pade customer se. But that, I think, is important. So I'm repeating, anything you do, convert that into a micro process before you go. Okay, stock availability is... It's a problem, you have to sort it out. There's no... There's nothing. There's nothing. But there are two things about stock availability. Because we generally think availability is the responsibility of the head office. Yeah, I think that's not true. Availability is the responsibility of the head office to deliver. It's the responsibility of the store and the retail organization to forecast. So if you look at it, many organizations have this, where they get the whole retail team, regional teams to come, and do a saying, okay, this line, how much do you want? So there's always one store manager who says this. You know this Metro shoes, na? Rafiq bhai. Yeah? There, the whole store team is fully involved in the buying. Fully involved. In fact, the store manager is responsible for the inventory availability. Okay, he doesn't get a salary, he gets a commission. And he's like an entrepreneur in the store. So if he's an entrepreneur in the store, for him, agar do juta nahi raha, nahi bika, to uska din ke dhyadi mein se 2 rupaya kam ho jayega. Because he gets commission on that. So when he orders, he's not only looking at saying ki what is the line, he also says, what should I ask for more? Okay, so therefore the service is very high. Now that they have given a tab to everybody and the whole company's inventory is available to them and they have been given and empowered the right to pick up any inventory from any distribution center, from anywhere, their availability has gone up. Their end of aisle from a technology, non-technology has gone up. So question is, there is a responsibility of ours to make the effort. Availability is not what is there on platform or paper or the shelf. Availability is what is there in your overall system, global system, and that part is yours. Yeah, but it has got a lot of process to do. Merchandisers have to do right. Planning has to happen. So this is a long. But I know that if you don't have stock availability, you get bashed in front of your customer. Haath jodke maafi mang lene ka. Yeah, have the ability to understand what is the option. Okay, I don't know if you go and shop in a sari shop. and look at an associate who's selling saris. You just see how they convert. See, because every design is a different design. So you don't go and look for one design. So they actually know to understand. And within 10, 12 questions, they've understood your need. And they will shift it to that sari which they have in stock. Very rarely do you find non-availability as a challenge, because they're able to swap it. Yeah. Anything else on this? I have two or three things left which I want to talk of. Again, fluctuation in pricing is a current challenge of the business, which means that online is selling more and offline is selling here. The only difference is there a value of experience? So yesterday, after the session that I did, there's a person who came from the audience and he was talking about to say, you know, how he goes to Godrej Nature's Basket and shops there, although he said he pays between 2 to 3% or 4% higher than what he would pay otherwise. So I asked him, why do you go to that shop if you're getting 2 to 3, 4%? So he gave me convenience, but he also told me of experience. So I was saying, what is the experience that you get? So he says that since I'm a regular, okay, more or less one person who knows me or the other person, they come to me the moment I enter, okay? So I'm just telling you how the customer is seeing the experience. Okay, second he said was that if I say something is not available, they make a note and they send it to my house later on. Third he said, which okay, he has an expectation saying that, you know, if my trolley is heavy or my basket is heavy, he carries for me. But that's okay, that's a different expectation that the person has. But his whole convenience experience was whatever I wanted, somebody in the store is willing to help me to achieve that. Yeah, so I think in each of your business, you have to say what is that element that you can do it, okay? In a shop-to-shop environment, what we have seen is that if there's a personal shopper attached, okay, the transaction goes up 3 to 4 times, okay? Which means basically there's somebody who's helping the customer to convert with alternatives which are available inside the store. I think that is the important part that you look at it. And that's the job that we are. Nowhere in the world you'll have 100% availability. Nowhere in the world you have challenges of price match happening, especially with the online coming in. Until unless you are a brand, you're very clear, this is what I want to do and I'm not willing to sell on online. But these are some of the perils of the industry. We have to learn to manage this. One of the things...
except India, you go anywhere in the world, anywhere in the world. So, say for example, a particular store is selling a Puma shoes for $200. The second store is selling the same shoe for $100. So except India, everywhere else is there's a price.
Because of one reason, India is the only country where you have an MRP.
Yes,
so therefore, you have a reference to match.
Yes. So I think we should not have, suppose the day we start getting that same thing here, then we'll have a more problem. I think we should not.
Yeah, but see, the fact is it's a worry. Because when the customer says, why is it available there at 70? But what happens, because there's an MRP and we work on discount, we don't work on pricing.
Right.
So if you look at it, these questions don't happen too much when it's private branding. Because they're then managing the price equation. It's only when it is a branded product being sold. In India, it is basically because of MRP, because you have a reference and we use discounts. That's also the reason why in India, discount has become the buzzword. See, globally, it is not discount. It's all about value pricing. Yeah, because people don't give this 1+3 fees happening more in India than anywhere else. But we'll go through this journey and probably over a period, we'll also correct this. But as of today, there is this... okay, so let me come to the final part of this, which is on the brand trust. So we discussed multiple elements of this. Yeah. Now, if you go back and think from a customer's point of view, that why she or he should trust the brand. Okay. One reason is that the brand has a bigger life than all of us. Yeah. So whether it's a Puma or a Skechers or a Shoppers Stop or a Lifestyle, it has remained for... Shoppers is now a 27-year-old brand in India. It's an Indian brand. Okay, but CEOs have changed. People have come and gone. People are going. So the brand is a much bigger proposition. Yeah. So anything that you do as an activity to deal with the customer, product, quality, value chain, you have to ask this question that how does it impact my brand? So brand gets impacted at every moment with a positive push and a negative push. Yeah? Let me give you an example again. This happened a long time back. I had some customer calling from Andheri station to say, Mr. Nagesh, there's a problem here. So I said, what happened? He said, no, there are two people fighting on the Andheri station. So I said, ma'am, but what can I do about it? She said, no, one of them is wearing Shopper Stop uniform. Now, please tell me, does it impact the brand?
Yes.
It has impacted the brand. But please tell me, do you have a policy which says that when you're wearing the Puma uniform, don't behave in a bad way outside? Don't have.
So some brand has a policy, like Samsung, right? You cannot wear the uniform outside.
Perfect. So now you realize, so therefore I'm saying a brand trust is a combination of multiple things that happen. And it is, again I'm saying, it is the culture. Okay, and this is the beauty of when you look at a culture or the DNA, that comes with multiple reinforcements. It doesn't happen because of processes. It happens because of the outcome of what you see, what you do, what you hear. So it's important that everything that we do, we look at saying, what is building the brand trust? And therefore, you have to be in your clear mind that, what, for example, let's take this. You have spent 2 days. I'm sure your companies will pay your salary for these 2 days. Yeah? You're coming here. You spend time, you listen to 10 people. The company must have sent you with some expectation. You must have come and sat with some expectation. If you go back and nothing happens, either to the company or to the process or the policy, or your store or your business that you're running, but nothing happens to you also. Yaar, 2 din Harish gaya tha. Yaar, aake wapas kuch farak hi nahi pada usko. Now, please look at what has happened. Ek to ट्रस्ट ब्रांड की ऐसी तैसी हो गई, ओके, हरीश की ऐसी तैसी हो गई, स्टोर की ऐसी तैसी हो गई, कंपनी की ऐसी तैसी हो गई, ब्रांड की ऐसी तैसी, ऊपर से उधर भी पैसा खर्चा किया, इधर भी पैसा खर्चा, आपको भी सैलरी दिया, यहाँ भी खर्चा हो गया. लुक एट हाउ इरोजन ऑफ ब्रांड हैपेंस. एंड दैट्स वाई इफ यू लुक एट इट, इफ यू जस्ट गो बैक अ लिटिल, इफ यू गो इन टू द हिंदी मूवीज, अगर लड़का बाहर पढ़ाई करने जा रहा है तो क्या बोलते हैं, बेटा अपने खानदान का नाम रोशन करना, बोलते हैं ना, ठीक है. और अगर लड़की जा रही है तो क्या बोलते हैं, अपने खानदान का लाज रखना. आर यू गेटिंग मी? नो, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज दिस लाज रखना एंड व्हाट इज दिस रोशन एंड व्हाट इज द खानदान, इज द ब्रांड. पुराने जमाने में दैट्स व्हाट ना, अरे श्रीवास्तव जी की घर की लड़की है यार, शादी कराओ, नो प्रॉब्लम्स. या अरे यार शुक्ला जी की बेटी है, बस नहीं जाने का. Please understand, Shivastav ji and Shukla ji, they are brands. And the brands get created over generations. Okay, so you have to, as managers, as supervisors, CEOs, whatever role you are. And again, I'm repeating, all of us say, ye sab to CEO ka kaam hai. Nahi. How many of you are CEOs here? All of you are CEOs. It says chief executive officer. So you are the chief executive officer of the store. You are the chief executive officer of the function. Designation nahi diya uski, aise kaise, who cares for the designation? It's what you do. So if you are the chief executive officer, then it is your role, at least jab tak company mein ho, jab tak salary leke jate ho, okay, jitna gali dena hai company ko, but at least ensure that what you do adds up to the brand trust. Whatever you do adds up to the family trust. And I think that's the only way the brand trust gets created. I mean, I know of, for example, I was just studying all the companies. Like I said, 7% per month is the attrition in this industry, what we studied last year. Compared to that, the attrition in Titan, I'm told, is 14% or 15%. So I was trying to check up, ki why is it this? So when we went deeper, we realized ki lot of family members, including parents, wives, spouse, children, okay, don't allow their father, mother who's working in Tata's to leave. So the trust has probably percolated to the family, although the family is not directly connected. Maybe ghar mein salary aata hai, hum khush rehte hain. So look at, and that's, in my opinion, Tata is the only brand in this country because it has lasted a century. A true brand is a brand which lasts a century and passes 3 generations of people. There are maybe other brands in jewelry and all which are run for 3, 4 generations, and people go blindly and buy that. So a brand trust is a culmination of multiple things that happens. We have been speaking over the last 1 hour, 1.5 hours, and all that put together makes the trust to happen. But again, I'm saying, Mr. Harish Bhatt, who is the brand custodian of Tata. I didn't even know. Harish was working earlier in Titan, then chairman of Tata Global Beverages. But Tata has a director level person whose role definition is brand custodian. His job is to see how can he ensure that the Tata brand is kept live, kicking, and all the ethos and elements which goes in the Tata brand continues. So if each one of you say, I'm the brand custodian, in what I do, you see how elements of trust will start building in. And if anything which comes back and customer says, you know what, I keep coming back to your shop because I trust you, make a note and check up what did you do for the customer to come back and say, I trust you. Put it into whoever is responsible. This is a small, small element, like I told you about the uniform. Okay. Or for example, ek aur cheez hua tha, and I'll close this. If you have questions, you can ask, we'll go for lunch. When we opened the children's section, Andheri, so I said the children's section, we should have some small creche. And we kept a qualified nurse in the creche because we said, boss, customer hai, bachcho ko kuch hona nahi chahiye. So one day, 11 o'clock, the store opened. We saw a couple coming in, a three-year-old coming in. And three-year-old playing, couple was doing something. And then we didn't find the couple. The three-year-old is there. 1 ghanta ho gaya, 2 ghanta ho gaya, 3 ghanta ho gaya, 4 ghanta ho gaya. We are saying, kya gabad ho gaya? And 1:30, 2:30, this couple comes hanging around and ticks the kid. We say, Ekman, please come. What are you doing? No, no, we trust Shoppers Stop. I said, boss, we had not opened the creche for you to leave. They left the kid and went off to work for half a day and came after. Now, this is, to me, trust. This is, to me, trust. So I wanted to beat them up. But what I said is, look at what you've done. You have created trust for a parent to leave the kid here and go away. Yeah, but then we stopped that because we said, tomorrow if everybody comes, we'll be running a creche, you know. So, but anyhow, that's what it is. I've tried to cover as much as your points, but coming from more, if you have a challenge, how can I sort it out, rather coming and giving a lecture on customer centricity. If you're okay to take a 5 minutes, 8 minutes delayed lunch, and you have questions, I can take it up. I don't know whether it solves your purpose, whatever the last 1.5 hours, if it is done, whatever you wanted me to. Because I have to report to Mr. Roy, no? Oh, feedback mechanism, Roy ko ja ke bolne ka, Roy, kaam theek hua ki nahi hua. Any questions you have, any doubts you have, any dilemma you have, anything you want to share, comment, anything?
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Anything from?
Yeah, this is what exactly, you know, when we started this session yesterday, we were talking about trust and various facets of the trust. You know, this is where, you know, we took an every individual, you know, into their own shoes, you know, what they are doing, and, you know, we were trying to understand. And this, given practical, you know, we were talking about their experiences, we were talking about what the trust certification scheme should talk about. And then linking those facets of the trust to the regulatory requirements into the shop, the practices and systems, what should be involved in the shop, and customer care. So exactly you touched upon those two elements which you talked about, practices and systems in the shop, and customer care mechanism. And these are the live examples what you shared. This really adds a lot of value to
Thank you.
Understand practices and systems in the shop and customer care.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day and enjoy yourself. Thank you very much. Thank you.